Brahman. So this is Manus, and today's topic is wave analysis. This wave analysis is also called as signal analysis. So what is mean by wave analyzer or what is mean by a signal analyzer? So as I said, both are same. So it is an instrument. It is an instrument or a device used to analyze the waves or signals. It is called as wave analyzer or signal analyzer. Used to analyze the waves or signals is called as wave analyzer or signal analyzer. And we have one more definition is there, but before going to explain or defining about the wave analyzers or the signal analyzers, first I would like to tell a most important point about the CRO. As you know that CRO is also an instrument or a device. It is also used to analyze the signal, but to analyze the signal in time domain analysis is called a CRO. So to analyze a signal in the time domain region, that instrument or that device we use in the time domain is CRO. So CRO is completely in time domain. Time domain analysis. But the wave analyzer or the signal analyzers are, we have one more we are having, that is the spectral analysis. So these are the devices used to analyze the signals in the frequency domain is called as spectrum analyzers or the signal analyzers. In the frequency domain, is called as wave analyzers, or signal analyzers, or spectrum analyzers. Yes, and one more, the most important point means to analyze the harmonic content. Also, we use the wave analyzers or the signal analyzers, but it is not possible in the CRO to analyze the harmonic. What is analysis is not possible in the CRO. Where you can see that here it is. The x-axis is frequency and the y-axis is amplitude. That is the x-axis and this is the y-axis. Whereas in the CRO you can see it is the time, x-axis is time and whereas y-axis is amplitude or the magnitude. You can write that. So this is the difference. It is in the time domain and it is in the frequency domain. And any signal or wave is consists of two main components. One is a DC component. Any signal or any wave consists of two components. One is a DC component and second one is a signal harmonic component. So whereas the signal or the wave, the term or the word we use interchangeably, sometimes we use the signal analyzers and sometimes we use the wave analyzer. So this is the wave and signal we use interchangeably. So depends on the conditions. So yes, I said it consists of two components. One is a DC component and second one is signal harmonic component. And so basic structure of basic block diagram of a signal analyzer. Basic block diagram of signal analyzers. It consists of an input. Second, immediately consists of a primary detector. Next one is a full wave rectifier. And the last one is a meter output. These are the main building blocks for a wave analyzer or for a signal analyzer. Means first one, input signal. I might tell small accurately from the right. So input signal which is to be analyzed or which is to be what is calculated. So that is first one is input signal should be given to the primary detector, and the output of this primary detector is given to the full wave rectifier, and this output of the full wave rectifier will be displayed in the meter output. Okay, this is nothing but a display point. So I would like to draw the block diagram of this wave analyzer and the signal analyzer is as follows. So first one, I said I am giving an input to a primary detector. What input signal you are giving to a primary detector? And this output of this primary detector is given to a full wave rectifier. And this full wave rectifier output is displayed in the meter reading output. This is the basic block diagram of a wave analyzer. And I would like to tell, so the input signal, so which is to be analyzed, you are giving to a primary detector, and what the primary detector will do, and what the full wave rectifier will do, and ultimately what output you will get. I will tell you this. The input signal you are giving to a primary detector, this primary detector will detect the input signal given at the input point. And this primary detector consists of LC combinations. This primary detector consists of LC combinations. This LC is connected in series, where inductor and capacitor are connected in series. And these two values of this inductor and capacitor can vary in such a way we can allow only the desired harmonic content and other harmonic contents this does not allow. So how this is possible means by changing or by varying the values of the inductor and the capacitor. So with that it will allow only the desired harmonic input signal or the desired harmonic signal and does not allow the other signals. So that is a primary detector, and this primary detector output you are giving to a full wave rectifier. So whereas AC input you are giving, so till this AC input the primary detector is detected and it is amplifying, and the output is given to the full wave rectifier. This full wave rectifier, it converts the AC input signal into DC output signal. So AC input signal into DC output signal. So this full wave rectifier is nothing but a full wave bridge rectifier, where four diodes consist of four diodes. Full wave bridge rectifier consists of four diodes, and I will draw the diagram also. This full wave rectifier, and it converts the AC into a DC signal. So whatever the AC into DC signal, the output value you can get in the meter reading output, that is the value, the numerical value of the DC output signal, you can able to see where it is in the meter reading output. You can able to see the output of this wave analyzer, the DC output wave analyzer signal. In this way you can analyze the signal. And next one I would like to tell you, so what is the different types of wave analyzers you can have. So but before that, I would like to draw this is isotherapy. A diagram I am drawing is the same thing. So the viewer, block diagram I have drawn, the same thing I am just drawing, the schematic diagram I am drawing for the same basic wave analyzer. So one more POL is the anemometer. So this is V1, V2, V3, and V4, and this is a PMMC anemometer. So where the output, so you can see that output. So that is the diagram of a, what is, block diagram previously I have shown, and this is what the, what is, schematic diagram. So you can able to see, this is the schematic diagram. So this is about the schematic diagram of the wave analyzer. So yes, this is what the C and this is what the L. So I said already, you can vary this L and C in such a way, so where it allows only the harmonic content signal, and it does not allow the other harmonic content signals. And so output, next it is going to fill your rectifier, it is converting AC to DC. So this output signal you can able to, what is, show the deflection in the PMMC galvanometer. So how much deflection it is showing in the PMMC galvanometer. So after that, it is connecting to a meter reading output. So the meter reading output will show the value, the actual value of the DC output signal. So this is about, and I said already, we have two different types of, what is, analyzers we are having. One is the frequency selective wave analyzer. Frequency selective wave analyzer, I am just writing. The first one is the frequency selective wave analyzer. Second is super heterodyne wave analyzer. Super heterodyne wave analyzer. So these are the two classifications of the wave analyzers or signal analyzers. So frequency selective wave analyzer where we use, and super heterodyne wave analyzers where we use, means. So So these two are uses in the two different conditions. First one we will use in the audio frequency range. Audio frequency range. Second one is radio frequency range. So yes, audio frequency range is 10 hertz to 10 kilohertz. That is the audio frequency range. And radio frequency range is 10 kilohertz to 18 megahertz. Simply, I can say that audio frequency is in hertz, whereas radio frequency is in megahertz. Thank you all.